Some of them couldn't drift apart in open water. Some confused the coast with the sea. And some suffered from mechanical malfunctions or broke the operation rules. Today, we show you epic clips of ship accidents. Watch until the end if you want to be amazed. You just witnessed the bow of the huge bulk carrier Grand Rodosi destroy the tuna boat Apollo S whilst moored at the wharf in Port Lincoln, South Australia. The cost of this 47-meter motorboat is estimated at $17 million. After the collision, it sank in just 15 to 20 minutes. Two tankers were fighting over the waters of Tanjung Kling. The MV Ocean Line rammed into the middle part of the MT Stravoko's port side. And here's what can happen due to incorrect use of an anchor. The boat crashed into the stern of a large ship in the port's water area. Take a look at the way this tugboat goes under in just a few seconds. This happened after a blast on a tugboat that was transporting diesel canisters meant for refueling a larger vessel. Out of seven people on the boat, three died. It appears that this footage is a great example of how not to dock. In 2010, Japanese whaleboat Shonanmaru II rammed into trimaran boat Addie Gill in Arctic waters.
Fuck.
The 24-meter boat cost about $1.5 million and was designed for anti-whaling operations. They were allowed to use blinding laser cannons. When the vessels came across one another, Shonanmaru II came up to the boat from behind and turned over 110 degrees.
They hit it?
Yeah, they hit it.
At first, the whaler distracted the crew with powerful water cannons and then rammed into Addie Gill. All of the crew members were rescued, but the boat itself sank. Now you can see an emergency stop of the BC ferry Queen of Oak Bay. Its engine was faulty. Mechanical malfunction is responsible for this accident as well. A container vessel lost control in Guangzhou port in China. And this moment features a crash between a ship and a barge, which rammed into the ship's starboard at full speed. The Marines are in shock. They are showing the huge hole which could have easily sent the vessel to the bottom of the ocean. Take a look at the aftermath when a container vessel crashed into a dock in the Tanjung Emas port in Semarang. While attempting to dock, a 1,200-foot-long cargo ship, Milano Bridge, got caught on the towering construction cranes on the dock, causing one of them to collapse on top of the ship. The Milano Bridge also impacted another ship, the Seaspan Ganges. This happened near disputed isles in the East China Sea, the site of vast potential gas and oil reserves. A Chinese fishing boat collided with a Japanese patrol vessel. The accident was a catalyst, sparking a diplomatic spat between two Asian countries. Japan detained the Chinese skipper of the trawler, which made him a hero in China. 35-year-old pilot of the soybean-carrying barge lost control of the vessel and it crashed into one of the bridge pillars, causing the bridge to collapse. Later, the pilot was fined 2,000 baht. Turns out he was operating the boat under an expired license that ran out in 2012. A terrible crash happened during the Super Yacht Challenge Antigua Regatta between J-Class yachts. Take a look. one yacht rammed right through the other. It fully crosses the stern, causing a person to fall overboard. As a result, both boats were damaged and immediately dropped out of the race. Two crew members received medical attention. The Marine Knutsen supertanker was making its presence known by repeatedly sounding its horn, but it looks like that yacht just ignored it. Its sail got caught in the supertanker's anchor, and the yacht was hit. Apparently, boats being hit by larger vessels is a common occurrence, and often it happens through the fault of the boatman. These people were just chilling on their yacht near one of Miami's restaurants. They did not suspect that in just a couple of seconds, a huge tragedy will take place. Another yacht crashes into the boat, not sparing the passengers and even those who tried to drag them out of the way. He struck that pole with absolute precision. Behind the wheel of this naughty jet ski is a 13-year-old boy who was moving towards the sun and did not notice the obstacle.
What the?
A motorized inflatable boat that crashed into a sailboat was unmanned after the boat's operators lost control. That's also what happened when the Andrea trawler collided with the Alexander von Humboldt. A large three-masted sail training vessel with 59 people on board, all due to the negligence of the sole crew member who was on the bridge. Neither vessel was seriously damaged. In Vladivostok Bay, a military ship crashed into the dock as a result of reverse gear failure. A pleasure boat that was being transported aboard a large vessel using... It looks like that boat had other evening plans. And now some shocking content. A girl crashes her dad's yacht.
Dad, I'm so sorry.
It looks like someone will have to live without a new iPhone. An intoxicated 32-year-old crashed into the other boats docked at Bayfront Park Marina in Sarasota, Florida. According to one of the users, this ship is making its way down the river when all of a sudden the bridge starts lowering. The MSC Opera's engine failed and it lost control when docking. Two tugboats that were directing the ship through Giudecca Canal tried to slow it down, but one of the chains connecting them to the giant liner could not withstand.